Every ultimate experience Ireland has to offer is always within reach with a 182 BMW. The ultimate bowl of chowder, seasoned with Atlantic salt air, the ultimate swim spot, even the ultimate scenic shortcut that happily takes way, way longer. Experience the ultimate with a 24-hour test drive from your local BMW retailer. Because owning your new BMW is always within reach. Visit bmw182.ie.
Welcome to Take Two Radio. We are pleased to bring you interviews with people in the entertainment and music industry, discussions and recaps of the four remaining daytime soaps, that's The Bold and the Beautiful, The Young and the Restless, General Hospital, and Days of Our Lives, as well as various other shows. For upcoming and previous shows, check take2radio.com, that's with the number 2, and you can find us on Blog Talk Radio, iHeartRadio, iTunes, and other streaming apps. Follow us on social media at Take Two Radio, and thanks for listening.
All right. Good evening, everybody. Thanks for joining us this evening. You are listening to Take Two Radio's Big Brother Recap and Discussion Show. I am Brandon, and with me, as they will be every week for the next few months as we do this show and talk about Big Brother, our summer obsession, we have Brandy with us tonight. Hi, Brandy. How are you?
Hi. How are you? Hi, everybody.
Hi.
Hello.
Well, I'm awake, so that's a good start. I'm so tired.
Awake is good.
Okay.
Definitely.
Yeah, well, mm-hmm. I mean, I'd love to be taking a nap right now, but that can happen after. Okay. Also with us tonight, our other co-host, we have Ellie. How are you, Ellie?
Hello. Hi, Brandon. Hi, Brandy. I'm good.
Hey, Ellie. How are you?
Seems.
I'm awake, too. I'm awake as well.
It seems like it's been a rough week for all three of us. We've just all been super busy, haven't we?
I think being awake is really a good thing for the Big Brother season anyways, especially if you're watching the live feed. So I think that's a plus that we're all awake. So it's a good thing.
It takes a little while to get back into their schedule. They're on constantly.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
Now, are you on the West Coast or East Coast?
I am central, so I'm straight down the middle.
Okay.
So.
Okay. Ellie.
I'm considered Pacific time. I'm in Arizona, so I can watch them live as it's actually happening, but I think we see the show last in the country.
Yeah. Well, I was just thinking in terms of the live feeds because I'm on the East Coast, so the Houseguests
don't
really get, you know, it's fun till late at night. Like on the West Coast, so like, you know, midnight their time, it's 3 a.m. over here where I'm at. And then there are mornings when I have to open the store and I have to be to work at, you know, I start at 5 a.m., so I have to be there by 4:30 to be ready. So, like, you know, over the summer, it's really rough for me to catch them. And this is actually the first season that I haven't had the live feeds in like 5 or 6 years. So I'm very disappointed in myself. But I do follow along the line and catch all the live shows and things while I DVR them because my work schedule is so ridiculous now. Anyways, enough about me. I don't like talking about myself. So, end of the show, finally, as we're 3 minutes in. Where should we start out with the, live eviction? Because there wasn't really much to talk about in the other episodes up until the live eviction. So, we had Tyler was our HOH for the week, which, you know, I kind of, whenever someone comes out and takes the first HOH, you're always like, well, it's going to depend on how they handle this week as to if they're going to, you know, be the target for the following week.
Right.
So Tyler he kind of went a little back and forth this week, or, well, last week, I guess. He's in an alliance called Level 6, if I'm... Is it Level 6, 7, mm-hmm. 8, 12?
Level 6.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Level
half the house. Exactly. That's what I hate about alliances like this. When they have huge numbers, like, it's not going to last. But they can try.
Yeah.
So, in his alliance, it's Tyler... Tyler and Kate.
Winston.
Well, Caitlin kind of joined in the last minute.
Mm-hmm.
Yes. Winston, JC.
Mm-hmm.
Goodness gracious.
Brett.
Brett. Okay. And now Bailey and Swaggy are on the other side of the house, right?
Yes.
Yeah.
So those two, not to switch gears or anything, but those two seem to have really set themselves apart from the rest of the house because they're together, which we'll get into later. But is it really that good of an idea to get into a family affair? We talked about this last week, but they really kind of put themselves in, you know, the target zone. Because as if I were Tyler, the first week, if you see a showman blossoming, I feel like it'd be easy to, you know, put those two up on the block and just, you know, squash that, you know.
Yeah, exactly. It's too early. Too early.
Yeah.
And
right.
I mean, we can see, like, even with, let's just take Caitlin as an example, we can see she is trying to get, it seems like, with every guy in there. I think
mm-hmm.
Steve may have been the only one that she wasn't interested in. And I can see how that's backfiring on her as well. So it does seem
mm-hmm.
like anytime there's any kind of romance or, you know, whatever, it doesn't go well. Usually it doesn't go well.
So we saw that Tyler went ahead and put up Steve on the block, along with Robot Sam. Now, what were your guys' thoughts on those two nominees? Do you think that was a safe bet? Do you think it was risky? What do you think, Ellie?
I think it was safe. You're going to put the oldest guy in the house who's also very calm, and then another person who you don't really have to look in the eye. So I just thought it was safe.
mm-hmm.
The robot eye.
For sure. All right. You feel the same way, Brandy?
Yeah, I thought it was safe. Steve was definitely a safe bet. And I think with Sam, it would have been interesting had he not had that conversation with Sam to know,
mm-hmm.
you know, if things would have gone differently and if Steve would have ended up staying.
Right.
Probably
yeah.
not, but it would have been interesting, you know?
Mm-hmm.
But I think it's good to keep Sam. I think that she was robbed, you know, the first week being that robot.
Mm-hmm.
That's tough. That's unheard of the first week, you know.
Right. It definitely made things harder for her to be able to fight for herself when, you know, when the people aren't really looking her in the eye. I mean, I guess she can see them,
mm-hmm.
I guess, through the camera. But, you know, she can't technically look them in the eye and, you know, show how honest she is or how truthful she is in her deals and things like that.
Mm-hmm.
Now, in terms of the POV, we saw that Fessy won the POV, and
mm-hmm.
he seemed to have thoughts of using it, correct? Like, he considered it.
Yeah, it seemed like it.
But
for a minute.
In the end, he decided, yeah, just, you know, it was, I don't know. I don't know what he thought his plan would have been if he would have used it, but seemed like it was a safe route again to not use the POV
mm-hmm.
and keep things calm in the house. So
right.
that left Steve and Sam on the block. Now, we talked about at the end of last week, because I think it kind of just happened like on our first show, but Sam was given the first power of the week through the BB App Store, which I'm still kind of like
yep.
trying to figure out how this all works. It's kind of a lot. It's kind of overwhelming when you look at all the different apps and the powers, like it's a different power every week. Seems like some of the powers
mm-hmm.
are similar. But Sam's was that she gets to correct me if I'm wrong, anyone, she gets to return to the game through some kind of competition if she's evicted. Is that the gist of it?
Yes.
Yeah. She has up to 4 weeks, I think, to use it. So I think, like, if, for an example, if she would have been voted out instead of Steve, then she would have used it and had to do whatever comp, which is, that's new as well. Usually if they use their power, not when they've used whatever their incentive has been in the past, they never have.
They just get
it. As far as I remember, yeah, they just get it. They've never had to work for it. So,
right.
And also,
I kinda like that.
Also, if she doesn't use this one at the end of week four, it does get used on whoever gets evicted. Isn't that part of it?
Oh.
Interesting.
I didn't see that part. Okay.
That would be.
I'll have to go back and double check.
Sure. Yeah. That would be.
Oh. That's kind of game changing if she doesn't use it.
It really is. Well, and she's kind of in an awkward spot right now anyway, because she didn't have to use it, but now everybody from level six is aware. Now she owes these people something, you know? Now what?
Mm-hmm.
You know? She's going to have to use it on one of them if they get put up, and I don't know. It just seems, I wish she could have maybe just not said anything, but I don't know. That's me. I always like to play outside of the house, so what do I know? I mean,
right.
Unless you're in there.
Well, the way that I look at it is that if she, how I would have done is I would have kept quiet about it, because like you said, now that people know about it, and now that she was saved week one, she's, you know, like you said, she's going to owe them at some point, and they're going to force her, I feel like, eventually to use it, because there's a slim chance of her winning competitions.
Yeah. I don't know. She's tough, though. I mean, she's a welder, so.
Yeah.
You know.
It's true.
Maybe.
So if there's, like, a endurance comp, there it could be something that she could fight for. Leading up to the live eviction, there was level six was working towards getting Steve out of the house, but they didn't quite have the votes. They needed seven or eight. They needed seven, correct?
Seven. Yeah.
Yep.
Yeah, to get him out, and they were trying to figure out who could be the seventh person they could reel in to get Steve out. Well, the person kind of just fell into their lap. Well, fell into Tyler's lap, no pun intended. So back to the showmances. It seemed as though Caitlin and Fessy were, well, Caitlin did say on the show that they were very close. They had become close.
Mm-hmm.
They had developed a friendship. Didn't say relationship, she just said friendship. It kind of almost looked like she took ownership of Fessy.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know. That's how I took it.
Yeah. Yes.
But then Fessy kind of seemed to take a liking to Haley, which Caitlin's kind of close to Haley as well. So what's your guys' take on the whole Fessy, Haley, Caitlin situation, Ellie?
I feel like Caitlin, it's just like you said, it's an ownership thing. And I mean, that doesn't really work out well in the real world. It probably isn't going to work out well in close quarters, which make things awkward.
Mm-hmm.
And she seems to throw a little bit of a fit. I don't know if anybody saw on the feeds that, and I think they actually showed it on the TV show as well, that, you know, Caitlin saw them in bed and then walked out and walked back in and asked Fessy about where the beads were to the bracelet that he broke.
Mm-hmm.
She was so passive-aggressive about it. It was like, oh, my gosh. If that's not so obvious that you're acting a little bit jealous. But she seemed to move on to the next man fairly quickly. I mean, she's in bed with Tyler now, so, I mean,
right.
I guess yeah, it's working out for her, I guess. On a side note real quick, Brandon, I just wanted to throw the number out if anybody wants to call in. The number to call if you want to chat with us, if you have any disagreements or agreements or thoughts, it's 718-506-5. 1540, and you're going to press a 1. And that number is also listed on the Blog Talk Radio website under Take 2 Radio.
Awesome. And then you can check out Take 2 Radio on Twitter to see the number if you missed that as well. So it's posted everywhere. So no excuses not to call and argue with us, guys. Call in.
Call in,
okay.
Please.
So, so Caitlin kind of was very upset when she saw Haley and Jesse together, even though it was just a close friendship. So the first person she went to when she found out about it was no one other than Tyler. She went to bed with him and was crying her eyes out, which I thought was a little bit excessive considering how long they've been together in the house. And she just felt, the basis of Caitlin's complaint was that she feels like she's at the bottom of the totem pole because there's these bonds in the house as in terms of Swaggy and Bailey, Steve and Scotty, and now Haley and Fessy. So she thinks that it would be smart to get out one of those duos, meaning Steve. So level 6 basically had to do nothing to get that other vote. It just fell in their lap, so to speak. And when the live eviction day came up, Baggy, I don't know why, Bailey and Swaggy, I guess that's their name, I don't know. So Bailey and Swaggy, their side, I don't know if that's it.
I kind of like that, Brandon. I like that.
I just said on accident, I'm like, hey, kind of accident works. Because, you know, it's not cute.
It's going to
stick,
I think. Right?
But, you know, I don't do showmances that often. Has to really be a couple that I can actually compete and, you know, that I enjoy. But,
yeah,
going into the live eviction, feeling pretty confident in the fact that Sam would be the one evicted. Because they thought that they had Caitlin on their side, but little did they know the whole Haley and Steve, not Steve, Haley and Steve, that's bad. Haley and Fessy situation. So the vote ended up being 7-6 for Steve to go home, which caught Bailey and Swaggy by surprise. And did you
their
guys?
Their facial expressions were perfect. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Their reactions
because
were great.
Because they acted surprised as well.
Yeah.
But
I thought Swaggy was going to lose it immediately.
Right. So it was smart of Caitlin to act surprised too, so that way no one would think that it was her. Granted, I thought her reaction was a little overdone, and I figured people would be like, oh, well, that must have been her that did it, because her reaction just was way too overdone. Of course, Caitlin's kind of a person who overdoes things in general. I guess it just depends on how you look at it. But were any of you guys surprised at the eviction vote? I mean, because I didn't watch the live feeds at all, so I didn't know how that played out on the live feeds. Brandy, what was your take on it?
No, I wasn't surprised with the voting at all. It fell right where I thought. I was surprised, definitely, like I said, humored by the reaction. It was definitely, you know, a blind side. And Steve's reaction and, you know, it just, I think it fell where it needed to for the first week that it had to be, you know?
Ellie, what was your take?
I agree. I think having any sort of overt, really surprised reaction like that during a vote that's going to be that close is silly if you know the game. I mean, there's times when you really think the whole house is going to go against someone and they might get a pity vote. Then you would be genuinely surprised if it went another way. But when it comes down to one vote, give or take your alliance, you should always – I felt like they should have been a little bit prepared. That was kind of weird.
Yeah.
Good point.
I mean, there's no reason
that
anyone should be comfortable.
That's very confident for your first 2 weeks. Too confident.
Yeah.
And I don't know if you guys have been paying attention, but it seems as though Tyler has also become a little more confident as well, extremely confident. which I guess he has reason to, but once you get to that kind of level of, oh, everything's going my way and everything's going super well and, I'm invincible, then that's the point at which I feel like you're most vulnerable to something going wrong. So I think Tyler needs to, watch his back a little bit.
Well, that's when the power's going to flip. And that's when it's going to really show their character, is if they can handle being the underdog for a couple of weeks. And if not, that's when they go.
Well, yeah. And it's always when the person exhibits too much cockiness or too much power, it seems to be their downfall if they're not handling it right. The house guest starts not like that, and then that's when they get ganged up on. So he's got to be careful. I think overall he really did have a good first week. And it seems like the second week's going pretty well for him as well, but I think he needs to keep it in check and, watch himself.
Because, you can never be too safe in the Big Brother house. When you think you're safe, that's the moment at which you're not going to be safe, because you're going to slip. Something's gonna slip through the cracks, and you're gonna be found out. And as much as I like Tyler, I think he's gonna have to watch his back. So Steve was evicted 7-6, and he was a little shocked, but also I feel like he shouldn't have been, because typically that's how every season goes. It's either the older guy, older girl, whoever seems to be the first one evicted, no matter what. And it's exactly how it happened. And, I feel like a lot of that also has to do with not being able to connect with the rest of the house guests, because the other house guests are, younger. So I feel like if, older house guests may not be able to build a bond or connection with a lot of the other house guests, because it's just, a different generation and things just don't mesh well. He did build a great relationship with Scotty, but, that...
But he didn't even campaign either, though. He didn't campaign not once.
Yeah.
So, how could you be surprised, really? That's what I would ask if I was Julie Chen, of course. But I would say, that's another form of the whole cockiness thing, where if you feel like you're that good, then you're really not. That's what it's going to flip on, I just felt like he didn't do anything.
And
he definitely wasn't
told,
Derek
level.
He
went against a robot. I mean, a little work probably would have went in his favor.
Oh, <embarrassing. laughs> That's such a great point, Ellie. He went against the robot. I love that. Because it's so true.
No one else can say that.
No. He did no work at all. He just sat back and smoked all week. I don't know. You got to make an effort. Come on. I don't know.
He did it to himself.
Oh, can I just say that I have a lot of law enforcement in my family and friends, and they can talk about a lot of things besides law enforcement.
Yes.
It's not a normal everyday conversation.
Absolutely. Did he talk about cars or mechanics once? I think only when he walked them out. I don't know. Come on.
I did like
if
it.
You're
he was a nice
Steve,
guy.
We do feel bad, but still, you had to work for it. Come on. He was a nice guy. Yeah.
Yeah. He had
Big Brothers are for nice guys, though.
Watched it.
That's true.
Yeah, he did.
So the next HOH competition ended up being one of the crapshoot HOHs, which can be fun, especially if you're looking for a power shift in the house. And it seemed for a long time that Scotty was going to win, because no one else could even hit the target. I don't know how many of them could not even hit any target that was out there. They all just hit either outside of the target or somewhere on the street of the game board, so to speak. So if Scotty gets in power, he's not even going to be able to do it. He's probably going to pass out. I don't even know how he's going to handle it. poor kid. Like, I'm starting to feel bad and anxious for him.
Bond left, you know?
Yeah.
His only true bond is gone.
So I guess if, you know, thinking back, if he would have, so I guess we're spoiling it, he didn't win. But if he would have won, this would have given him kind of an opportunity to find someone else in the house that he can trust and, you know, maybe work with. Of course, he also has to be careful of that because being HOH, people are just going to tell him what he wants to hear. So it would have been up to Scotty to be able to figure out, well, who's being genuine with me right now and who's just saying this to, you know, get my vote. But anyways, he didn't win. So, funny enough, considering what happened that week prior, Caitlin's the new HOH, which I guess you can say Tyler's in power again for a second week, you know?
Yeah.
Like, what's your take on Caitlin being HOH, Brandy?
I just think she's just awkward. I same thing I'm going to say about her HOH is that is the most weirdest HOH letter that I think I've ever heard from any season. It was just a weird letter. Like, I don't even know. Like, I don't know. It was just odd, but I guess it fits kind of her character because some days she's a little odd too. Yeah, it does. Right. It kind of is who she is. I think she's just, at this point, I just think she's, you know, trying to find love. I just don't know about game-wise if her head's in it. So, I don't know. I wouldn't have wanted her. I wasn't cheering for her to get it, personally.
Hey guys, I'm interrupting for a second because you have a caller.
Yay!
We have Ziggy calling in. Say hello, Ziggy.
Hello.
Ziggy, what's up?
Oh, hello.
Hello.
Tell us how you're feeling. Give us your thoughts.
Well, are we doing spoilers or anything?
Oh, sure.
I mean,
do whatever. Yeah, I gave spoilers.
Yeah,
I'm all for
spoilers. Just a warning to everyone listening. Spoilers are about to happen, so either turn away or mute for the next second.
I don't know exactly where you guys were talking, but I was just making a comment about, I understand about Caitlin. She's just crazy. And it was a fun couple of hours of feeds because she put Swaggy up on the block. I also have to say it's not entirely her fault either. I see it also as in if you're in an alliance, you need to keep that alliance going at all times. And as soon as she became HOH, I don't remember one of them, like, sitting down with her saying, like, all right, like, as an alliance, what are we going to do, like, try to get in her head? And then they also barely picked up on the fact that Tyler was talking to her the most. Well, then get upstairs and start talking to her yourself, you know?
Right.
So it's kind of their own fault, too, that none of them really solidified the alliance and talk to Caitlin because she's, I believe she's bipolar. I'm not sure. and I think the last person that got in her ear and made her cry and feel special because that's all she needs is attention, they probably would have got what they wanted done. You know what I'm saying? So that was just my comment for the day.
Yeah. What do you think about her trying to have a romance with everybody? What's your thoughts on that?
I think she just likes attention, basically.
Yeah.
And any man at this point is going to give her attention she's going to listen to. And I don't know what Tyler has in his eyes, but all he has to do is look at her, and she's like, okay, whatever you want. So I don't know.
So true.
Yeah.
So true.
That's great point.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Well, thank you for calling in, Ziggy. We appreciate it. And be sure to call back in next week with thoughts on what happens this week, because who knows what's going to happen.
All right. Thank you.
Thank you, Ziggy, very much.
Thank you.
All right, bye.
So it's good to have these
attention. It is. It is what it is, attention. And you know, a female might be able to give her that same attention.
Mm-hmm.
If they figured out how to talk to her right.
Mm-hmm.
Right. I think so, too.
It's the question is if she would actually listen to someone, another female in the house, if she would be able to trust them and take that advice that they would give her, for example. But
mm-hmm.
that remains to be seen because she seems to be so in tune with Tyler. I'm assuming probably that the reason she's so in tune with Tyler is because their auras are matching. That's probably the only reason that they're so in tune.
Of course, that's why.
It's the only thing that makes sense. So
did she read his
Caitlin
palms
got her,
or something, though?
I mean, she probably did more than that, but that's neither here nor there. So as soon as Caitlin got in power, I kind of got a feeling of power hungry. She was a little power hungry with it, which you know tends to happen with someone who is not, I guess, used to being in power, and someone who you wouldn't expect to win HOH. Like I wasn't expecting Caitlin to win, but you know, it being a crapshoot HOH, it's up in the air for anyone. So she seemed to be fairly certain as to who she wanted gone. But her initial plan was that she wanted to put up two pawns, which happens a lot, before she actually goes for the person she wants out. And as Ziggy said when she called in, that she wanted to put up Swaggy as her main, the person she wants to get out. But in order to do that, she has to backdoor him. So her mm-hmm. thought was she wanted to put up Winston and Scotty. Now, poor Scotty. Oh, my goodness. Poor Scotty. He was standing in the storage room talking to Fessy and was it Tyler or Brett? I don't remember.
It was Brett.
It must have been
okay,
Brett.
It was one
yeah.
of the buff guys.
Mm-hmm.
And he was eating yogurt, literally shaking. He couldn't even scoop the yogurt because his hand was shaking so much because Caitlin had already told him that she wanted to use him as a pawn.
Mm-hmm.
And this, you know, after what happened last week with his, you know, closest ally.
Yeah.
You know, Scotty was not too keen on the idea.
Yeah.
And, like, I can understand, right? Like, you guys could probably feel where he's coming from. Like, you're told that you're not going to be sent home, but your person last week was not going to be sent home, and look what happened. You know?
Yeah.
So,
and how's that going to play out? Let's say, you know, so Scotty and Winston, if it was just left at that, I mean, Scotty's really not a threat right now. He's somebody that can actually be a pretty good asset. Winston, on the other hand, you know, if those two nominations were to stay, I mean, Winston and Brett need to be broken up a little bit, I think, you know? I always kind of go for breaking up any of the alliances that can be broken up. And I think that's an easy one with, you know, minimal damage.
Right. So, yeah, you brought up a good point about Winston and Brett. Did you guys see how they were basically dressed exactly the same for the eviction ceremony? I was like, that's cute. Are they going to like start braiding each other's hair now before the eviction ceremony and shaving each other? And like what? How's this relationship going to play out?
I think they do
shave
each other.
I mean, it's cute and everything. Like it's almost like
a whole Miami Vice look. You know, like with the cutoff shirts and all that.
I found it a little douchey. I don't know how else to word it, the way that, you know,
mm-hmm.
like they didn't even button their shirt. Like it was kind of like a formal event. Like everybody was super dressed up for it. And then they just had these shirts unbuttoned, you know. I mean, sure, it was a great look,
mm-hmm.
something to look at. But, you know, I don't know. I just found a little stupid and unnecessary. A little cocky, too, I guess, is how I look at it. But I guess if you have it, flaunt it. I don't know. So we were talking about Scotty having a breakdown. So Caitlin, well, Fessy went to Caitlin to ask her to kind of bring Scotty down a little bit because, you know, she has that power. Oh, my throat hurts. So she went and talked to Scotty about her plan, and basically it was just her reassuring over and over and over again that he was not going to be the target, and she's like, it'll all make sense in the end, is what she said. Which, you know, it's hard to trust, looking at it from Scotty's side.
Absolutely.
I would be a little hesitant, right?
Definitely. Yep.
Like there's, you don't know what's going on in other people's heads, but no matter how much you trust them, especially with it being so early. So she did her best to talk him down, and when the actual nomination ceremony took place, he didn't really seem surprised when his face popped up on the screen. And then also along with that, Winston was nominated as well. Which this,
and
we didn't take too kindly
that
to
he's
that.
Safe, of course. Yeah.
Yeah, yeah. Well, being the guy that he is, the cocky kind of guy that he is, I wasn't surprised by that kind of reaction. So what are your guys' take on the Winston and Scotty nominations, Brandy?
I think, like I said, I'm good with Winston going. I did like him. He was actually part of my top three. But I just think that he has just the same word that you used. I feel like he's kind of douchey. Like, I have a hard time each season with the cockiest of players. Jesse, I couldn't stand Jesse's attitude. When they're just on this other level of, I don't know, I just have a real hard time with it, and I just feel like that's where he's headed. So I'm great if he goes. I'd be not happy if Scotty were to go. I think Scotty has a lot to offer. He just needs to kind of come out of the shell a little bit more. So.
Right, yeah. Ellie, what are your thoughts on the nominees?
I also agree that I think Scotty has a lot to offer, more than I thought on preseason interviews. I actually am starting to really like him. He has good intuition. Not that it takes deep intuition to understand the pawn goes home, but he's seeing that her story, her reasons aren't adding up. I like that he's thinking it through. Really quick, back to Caitlin's letter.
Yes, so, let's talk about it.
So I was part of the group, I don't know, many Big Brother years ago when we used to read really deep into the letters. I don't know if people still do that. Okay, I would have always thought that those were code for something. I mean, that letter was odd.
Very. It was so out there. But I don't know, code-wise, I don't even think that Caitlin would even think that. I just don't even.
Yeah, and she didn't really change her strategy based on it, so probably not.
Right. That's a good point, though. That's what HOH letters used to be. This just seemed like it was all over the place.
I mean, who was the letter from? Was it her mom?
Yes,
her grandma. And
that was her mom.
Wasn't it her grandma? I think it was her mom. Somehow, what stuck in my head is something about the spirit of her grandmother or grandfather. Do you know what I'm talking about, where she mentions
that?
Yeah,
because the bird, the spirit.
Okay, that's right. The bird, yes, yes, yes. Okay, yes. Okay.
The letter talked about a new baby. It talked about a new patio, maybe a dog.
Yes, the dog. Yes.
But,
I don't
know. Maybe that's
really
how
weird.
The family is.
Maybe.
I mean.
But I do like Scotty, and I do think that he definitely has a game to play.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. I mean, we talked about could have the ability to be like an Ian or something like that, and because he seems to have that kind of brain, at least.
Mm-hmm.
Of course, it's going to depend on how he chooses to use his skills in the game. If he chooses to, you know, actually team up with people that that can help him get farther.
Mm-hmm.
But. I mean, I feel like he's smart enough to figure that out and do that, but that remains to be seen.
Okay, interruption, guys. Sorry, I have to interrupt you again. We have another caller.
We have
Anastasia.
Oh, this is going to be good.
Say hello, Anastasia.
Hello. Man, I have a question. I don't know where
you're
seeing me, apparently. Hi, Brandon. Hi, Brandy. Hi, Ellie.
Hey,
hello.
How are you?
Oh, I have so much. Oh, my goodness. This season is really full of douchebags. I'm just going to say it.
Tell us about it. Let's get this out here.
First of all, any dudes that are wearing denim vests in the summer, well, period, not just in the summer, but in general, just need to go home. I don't know why those girls even let them wear those on national television. They're never going to get a date
again,
ever.
They can date each other. That's okay, though.
Oh, my gosh. I'm like, what in the – I go to music festivals. I don't see that weird shit at music festivals. Like, people don't wear denim vests.
No.
So –
it was kind of Miami
Vice-ish. No, it's like the Duke boys meet Jersey Shore.
Oh, that's right. That's
perfect.
Oh,
yeah.
That's bad.
Yeah, it wasn't a good look. I literally dropped my phone when I was watching, and I went, oh, are you kidding me right now? So, let's see. Who else can Swaggy? You know, I can't wait till he goes home. I just can't. I know Ellie likes him, but then I think about it and I'm like, this season would be really boring without him and JC. So now I almost kind of want to stay.
But what is he doing, really? He's climbing the wall. He's got that much.
Right now, he is, but. He's just so over the top. And those people come across as really fake to me. So,
and
not
the shirt,
a fan.
You know? I'm not a fan of the whole nickname thing. I don't know. Just not vibing with me.
I think he's hoping to get some sort of notoriety out of this, like to turn into, some social media God or whatever, you know, and I just can't get down with it. So, but I like JC though. And I know at the beginning you guys were all like, like before the season started, but he's really, really growing on me.
He is. I mean, talk about a comeback kid from preseason to now. It's so fast.
Yeah, I mean, I sat there watching him, like, they were sitting around the table having dinner or whatever, and he just, like, put his head on Fessy's shoulder. It was just, like, sitting there. I was like, that's just so cute. I'm like, you just kind of want to take the little guy home.
No.
Yeah.
I mean, hide your minions.
No way.
Hide your stuffed animals. But, yeah.
No.
So. And then
and your ice cream scoopers, apparently.
Like, there's a lot of controversy with these guys, and I don't think they're very what do I want to say, socially aware.
Mm-hmm.
I think they forget that they're on 24/7. I think that they forget that at points during the day, you know.
I mean, even now I'm having to be very, very conscious of the things that I'm saying, not in, I mean, dropping some profanity or anything, but so I think it would be really hard to be under that microscope all the time.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Absolutely.
Oh, yeah.
And depending on what part of the country you're from, different things you say are different PC. I think it's just everyone's from such different cultures. Not
you
that
know,
an ice cream scoop is okay in any part of the country.
Right.
I was going to say, whoa, and neither is hold up on the Minions, too. I mean, JC, I couldn't, listen, you all know, in the beginning with the Minion thing, I couldn't do it. And I was starting to be okay, and then the ice cream scoop, I'm like, God. But I still like him. He is growing on me as well, so I get that. But come on. He's a little sexual deviant or something.
Whenever anyone is sad or down, he's just really nice and really kind to them.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
He is.
And I mean, I don't understand why he hasn't gotten, you know, well, I mean, it is only week two of the Power App, so I get that. But hopefully he does get a Power App at some point and doesn't get the crap app.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Because he's just so, I don't understand why people wouldn't like him, minus the ice cream scoop and the dirty deeds with the Minions. But I can get beyond that.
Give him a few weeks. I think people will probably get over it. I think he's almost there, I think. He had a rough start, though. The Minion thing, that was on fire before, you know, a week or more before that he was even in the house. So, you know.
So, and Caitlin, I just can't with her. I mean, even today, Caitlin was in bed with Brett and he was straddling her and rubbing her exotic oils on her back and popped her top. And she was talking about moaning. And I thought, girl, you're a hoe.
You're on TV.
Because
so, wasn't last night she just playing with Tyler's hand saying she wanted to kiss him?
Yes.
Okay, so she's
she's making her rounds.
Maybe her and JC should just hook up. I mean, why not? I think maybe they should do.
Get it out of the way.
Then he just wanted to do that.
But, yeah, it's hard for me to choose. I mean, normally I can pick a favorite, like, right from the get-go, and I just haven't been able to, like, pinpoint, like, ooh, that's who I want to win, or ooh, that's who I think's going to win.
Mm-hmm.
And normally
who do you
I never
want
get
to
it
win?
Right. Who do I want to win?
You had to make a choice tonight. Who do you want to take
off? If I had to make a choice tonight, I would say Tyler.
Tyler, agree. I was about to ask your thoughts on him.
He's just kind of like that hippie surfer guy that's just laid back, like whatever. But then he's a deep thinker and he's kind of got bases covered. I think maybe he's spreading himself a little too thin right now and he's going to get caught. But I think I think he comes across as, you know, yeah, I'm just like this surfer kid and at home I like to smoke weed and, you know, just do whatever. But then he's always like thinking.
The way that he's been babysitting HOH, I just feel like he knows what he's doing somewhere. He's not just a surfer pothead.
Yeah. He knows what he's doing, but they don't know that he knows what he's doing.
Yes.
I mean, we can see
exactly.
It, but they're too busy running around and, you know, worried about who's aligned with who. We don't care about that. We don't care. I mean, we don't mm-hmm. have that in us where we have to worry about that. We're just watching, and we're able to say, yeah, he knows what he's doing. We're able to see all of the rooms and watch the feeds and know what conversations are being had. So,
mm-hmm.
so I think, yeah, maybe they're underestimating him right now. I like Sam. I just haven't really seen enough of her this week. We saw her last week, but now she's kind of taken a back burner. So
yeah.
I
like Sam. Sam's good too.
And I kind of like Rockstar. I mean, just because she's quirky and weird, and I like quirky and weird. Not Caitlyn weird, but like, you know, she's just like, I've got purple hair and I wear like hippie dresses, and you know, I probably smell like patchouli. I'm down with that.
That's awesome.
So
I'd like to see Rockstar that like do, because I feel like she has a good social game. And I feel like that could actually take her far if she chooses to, you know, really use that to her advantage. Not sure how she can do in comps, but I thought she could be really likable, and people would, you know, want to take her pretty far. I don't know.
And I think maybe they, I think if Swaggy leaves, you know, they did have a point where we can kind of start over. We don't have this huge personality mm-hmm. that's coming in and telling us all what to do and where to go and how to vote and who's going to do this and who's going to do that, which is, I mean, Swaggy came in and he just kind of took over everything, him and his ego. So mm-hmm. I think it will give the rest of them a chance to kind of feel their way out and find, or I mean, they've probably been feeling their way out now that they know that, yeah, he's probably going home. But
mm-hmm.
I don't know. We'll see. Some of them I'm just like, yeah, you're too over the top and too, like, I don't know. When you watch their diary room and mm-hmm. then you see the live feed, you're like, you are so fake in your diary. And, you know, they're like, oh, America. That, and then, you know, you see them in the house in the live feed and they're like sitting around like, like Steve. Steve's just like smoking his cigarettes, not saying anything. But in the diary room, he's talking about how much of a he is. I'm like, no.
Yeah, exactly.
So,
yeah. Excellent.
So, all right, guys. It was nice talking to you. And I'm going to go back to enjoying the show.
Thanks for calling in, Anastasia.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Thanks for calling.
Bye.
Bye.
She was fun. I like her.
Poor Swaggy.
I don't know.
Okay. All right. So let's just finish up with a spoiler. So as Ziggy mentioned, Swaggy, wait, so we can confirm that he is on the block or not yet?
So we didn't say who won POV. Did we say who won POV yet?
No, we didn't.
Do it with the disclaimer, probably.
Yeah.
Right?
So warning, in the next 5 to 7 minutes, spoilers will be given out. So tune in or tune out, however you want to do it. Okay. So I didn't watch the feed. So who was the POV winner?
I don't know how to pronounce his name properly. With the F.
Oh, Fessy.
I'm going to say it wrong. Fessy won, right?
For last week, but. For this POV, it was Caitlin, I believe. No,
it was actually you. Hold on, I'm checking real quick. I'm sorry.
I know we're having our weeks mixed up. I think is what's happening. Tyler did
the POV.
Tyler.
Oh, you're right. It
Tyler
was Tyler. And Tyler did use
yeah.
it.
Mm-hmm. He saved little Scotty. Scotty's safe.
So, with that, Caitlin decided to nominate, who was it in his place?
Swaggy.
Big Swaggy.
Mm-hmm.
That's where the Tyler power thing is adding up one on top of another. Because even though he's not HOH this week, he has the HOH here.
And I think, I think he's made a really good decision because if you think about it, now Scotty can be part of their crew if they wanted to kind of recruit him
mm-hmm.
too, you know?
Yes. Well,
so
he has
one more
trust
for
now.
Them.
Yeah.
And Swaggy,
so,
I don't know.
You got two very powerful bros on the block this week, which doesn't really happen so early, I feel like. So this is kind of a unique situation.
Mm-hmm.
So it seems as though Swaggy's going to be the one going home, but well, what do you guys
you
think?
Never
do you
know.
Think that's what's going to happen? I mean, it's pretty early, right?
It's very early.
It's mm-hmm. And just kind of reading over some of the feeds from today, because during the day, I don't watch it as much because of work, but it seems like Caitlin is kind of feeling bad for Swaggy from what I'm reading on some of the updates, which, I mean, I don't know. She needs to get a grip, I think. But, if things align how the alliances are supposed to, then he's going. But it'll be interesting to see if either one of them start campaigning, you know, instead of just sitting back like Steve did.
Well, I feel like both Winston and Swaggy are going to, you know, play hard this week. I mean, maybe Winston won't. Now that he sees that Swaggy's on the blog, Winston might get a little comfortable. So it'll be interesting
mm-hmm.
to see how Winston plays off this week. But I'm sure Swaggy will be going, 100 miles an hour, going full force, trying to save himself. Things can change on the flip of a dime, you never know, but from the beginning, it's still in full effect as we speak, so we have three more days until the actual eviction, so I guess we will see if Caitlin can actually carry her plan all the way through to live eviction
mm-hmm.
night.
Yep, we shall see.
Mm-hmm. Any last thoughts, guys?
I just had a quick question on how you guys are feeling about the with CBS giving out their warning so soon in the season, as far as the PC kind of what Anastasia touched on. What do you guys think about that being given, first being given and then given so early, as far as for the house guests to kind of watch what they're saying? What are your thoughts on that?
I mean, I think it's just more of a precaution right now for them after, what's happened in the past. I feel like this season so far has been fine, but, in the past become more and more of an issue. So they're just, I guess, in a way, trying to get ahead of a situation that may happen in the future. Like, I don't
mm-hmm.
I think it's good that they're doing that. I just hope that if something does happen that's very controversial, that, Julie can address it with that house guest and, make sure they hit it head on
mm-hmm.
and try to figure out how to remedy the situation.
Mm-hmm. What do you think, Ellie?
It sounded like a strong warning, but no specifics, if I'm right. So it sounded like they were very serious, but those house guests, if you don't know you're saying something wrong, you don't really know you're saying something wrong. So I like that they're trying to get ahead of it. It might not have worked, but I think CBS is just trying to not have a repeat of things that have happened in past seasons.
Mm-hmm. Exactly. Yeah.
If somebody said to me 2 weeks into something, you need to remember you're being watched 24/7, I would probably rein it in. That'd be a scary warning.
And I remember JC saying, I don't know what he said. I don't think it was anything bad, but I remember seeing him on the feed and him kind of covering his mouth and saying, oops. So I think they're definitely more aware now.
Yeah.
Hopefully they'll continue that. So.
Mm-hmm. Well, I guess we will see how the season goes. I feel like with the different kinds of personalities they have this season, that there's bound to be something. It'll be sad that someone's going to win. So, just wait a week, maybe just a couple of days.
Yep.
All right, Brandy, do you want to wrap us up for the week?
Yes, I do have a trivia question for you guys. Thanks, everybody who called in, first of all. Looking forward to the eviction night, of course, as always. And the trivia question tonight, here you go. Ready? This is an easy one. Come on now. All right. What year did Big Brother first season of Big Brother start? What year?
Should we guess?
2000.
Definitely. 2000. Yep. That's it.
Was it 2000?
I was hoping I might throw. It was 2000. I was hoping to throw somebody
good
off.
Job.
Because,
good job, Brandon.
Yeah. I know, Brandon.
I thought it was 1999.
It's because, remember, one of the seasons had a winter.
Yeah.
And there was.
There was an all-star season, too.
Yeah, exactly. Well, so.
That winter season was something, wasn't it? Did you guys watch that?
Yes. Yeah.
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 That,
we'll
was that eight or nine?
I think
that
it
was
crazy.
Yeah. Okay, yeah. That was a good season.
It was good. And even though I don't like the idea on its face, it worked for dynamics.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Right.
Definitely. Nope.
All right.
Well, good job, Brandon. Good guess. I'll have to trick you next week.
I was going to say, a little hard. Try something a little more challenging next week.
I will. Don't you worry.
All right, guys.
Before you guys hang up, wait a minute, because you all hung up last time except for one person, and that was Brandon. I just wanted to say good show and wait for it.
Yay team.
Excellent. All right.
And so happy that we had callers tonight. So all you people listening out there, see, it's not hard. You don't have to be shy. You don't have to be scared. Give them a call. They were great. So thanks to Anastasia and Ziggy both for calling in.
They were great.
We don't bite.
Thanks for all the listeners who are following along and following our Twitter pages and, you know, without you guys, we would just be talking to each other. So thank you guys for tuning in. And thanks, Ellie and Brandon, as always.
Yeah. And why don't you guys give out your Twitter names, too?
Okay.
You can
find
me
on Twitter at...
Go ahead, Brandon.
Okay. I love the delay. It always confuses us. You can find me on Twitter at OUBrandon14. I'm trying to be more active than I used to be, so bear with me. I'm very busy, but I'll probably tweet about the shows like 4 days after they actually air, but I'll tweet about them eventually.
Go ahead, Ellie.
Brandy.
Okay, I'll go.
Okay.
my Twitter, we're all going to go at some point. My Twitter is Brandy Talk Radio. BRANDI Talk Radio, and just want to also throw out there the bingo, Big Brother bingo game is still going on. We still don't have any winners. It's on my Twitter page.
Oh, I need to do Big Brother Bingo. I need to remember that. Write that down. And I'm on Twitter, yeah. Ellie Online 13.
Okay, thanks, guys. And we'll see you again next Monday at 9 p.m. Eastern. That's 8 Central. And what time, Ellie, by you? 7 or 6?
6. 6 Pacific.
Okay, I've got that. Sometimes you have to think about it in your head, you know, with the time differences that makes you crazy. If everybody was on the same time and there was no fallback or going forward, you know, we'd all have our heads together, but you know how that goes. So, all right, thanks, everybody. Have a great night.
Thanks. Bye, guys. Have a good night, everyone. Bye-bye.
Thanks, Sam.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
Get connected with Take Two Radio on Facebook or Twitter at Take Two Radio. For email updates on future shows, follow at Blog Talk Radio. For previous episodes, upcoming guests, and more, visit TakeTwoRadio.com.